right. Thank you.
So we were talking about, you know, we had our fun talking about the dogs, talking about the chinchillas. Now we need to get to business because it is business to business.
Okay.
Right. The business part of it.
I'm ready.
Is okay. You started out of your home.
Yes.
Now take us from your home to now, 2009.
Okay.
Okay. In 5 minutes or less, to talk to us about how you got started. How did you prospect? Did you need a loan? Who helped you, et cetera, et cetera? So others can know,
you know,
that
they
can do
this. Plans, your proposals, your loans, you know, step by step, like she said, where, you know, how you got to this point.
Well, started off just with Craigslist, trying to get a couple of clients, which I got a couple of clients, and I registered with Pet Sitters International. And that's a great website to, if you're going to look into the pet care business, because you put your sign up for, it's like $113 a year, and you sign up, has your information, and it's done by your zip code also. So if a person is looking for a pet sitter in their area, they just type in the zip code and your name pops up.
Okay, good.
And I cover a wide range. So I go to Jersey, I go to the Bronx, I go to Brooklyn.
Good. Right.
So she's hustling.
I am hustling.
Okay, go ahead. All right.
I am hustling. Uh-huh. But at first, it was a slow start. Mm-hmm. So I didn't have anything to start with. I just started with what my last check. And it really wasn't that much, because for pet sitting, only thing you need is a couple of treats. Mm-hmm. And everyone else provides leashes.
I'm in the wrong business.
But when they stay with you, that's the harder part.
Okay.
So when I do not do crates or cages, like a lot of people go to, they send them to kennels. Mm-hmm. I don't do that.
Right.
So their home is just like my home. They can roam free. And the cats, we had a talk. And they're used to it. They know that they're just going to stay for a little bit. And the cats stay out of the dog's way. If sometimes we have a little friction. Some dogs don't get along with some cats. Some cats don't get along with. And we have different rooms that we keep them in and separate them. But everybody's happy.
Okay.
Everybody's.
So let me just ask you, what is your long-term goal? You know, what is it you're trying to achieve? I know you want to get out of the house.
Oh, yes.
So, but what is your long-term goal with your business?
Right now, I'm looking to expand.
Okay.
I'm looking into storefronts to have a Harlem-based one-stop shop in Harlem, because we don't have that now. We don't have I'm trying to open a doggy daycare with the pets, and it's all going to be organic.
Okay.
And I'm actually looking into branding, starting my own leashes, my own organic cookies.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
All these treats
for
the dogs.
All these treats.
Yeah. So it'll be like a whole food for dogs.
Yes.
So did you have to get a small business loan even to start a business out of your home, or what happened?
Not really. Okay. I had a direct loan, you can say.
Okay.
And then I was in school. I was in school, and I took that after it was used for school. I used the rest of that,
and I bought
my Jeep. So that's able for me to go and get many more clients, and during the day I can take them to the dog run.
So how do you pick up clients now? It's just basically your referral.
Go to the actually it's word of mouth.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Word of mouth. I've gotten so good, and people love me so much that it's just word of mouth.
Wow. So, and that's the best way.
That's the best way.
Right.
It is the best way. But until I open the storefront, I'm going to use direct mail. I'm going to have direct mail.
So what is your projected, now, is that a new business plan you have to create? Or
well, I didn't even start the business plan. Mm-hmm. I just went off with
your idea.
My idea. With it. So this is my first time making a business plan.
Okay.
Oh, wow. That's almost like what they were talking about last week.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're going to take it from that step. The business, you know, you started the business with your idea.
Yes.
And you work through your idea.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're going to create the business plan.
Yes.
And I notice a lot of businesses, they do just create their business and then go back. So they can get focused as to exactly where they want to be.
Yes.
So, and create their business plan.
Mm-hmm.
So just tell us, for a person, like I said before, a young kid or a student who's interested, or anybody for that matter, that may be interested in the pet care business, what is the main advice would you give someone that's going into it?
Yeah.
Besides loving animals, obviously.
That was the first thing.
But I'm just saying.
That is the first thing.
But in terms of the business aspect of it.
The business aspect of it, there are a lot of dog workers out now.
Mm-hmm.
So
I see a lot of them.
After I started,
how much do you charge?
Well, I charge $20 an hour.
$20, and how many hours do you need to be walking?
And imagine
an hour. Exactly.
Yeah, oh my
exactly.
God.
And that's per day.
Hour.
And that's per day. You
oh
just
my
five.
That's $200 in 1 hour. That's $200 in 1 hour. Just walking.
Wow.
Guys walking around with 10 dogs at a
exactly.
time.
Exactly.
Yes. No.
Exactly.
What? Have you had?
But that's
okay.
just me.
Downtown,
they probably
mm-hmm.
charge more.
I have a question.
Sure.
Have you had any accidents with the dogs? I mean,
I have.
You have to have dog insurance.
You definitely have to have dog insurance.
Okay.
Insurance, you have to be bonded and insured. Some of them are not,
mm-hmm.
but that's just if something happens, it's all on you.
Right.
When I was bonded and insured, like I said, through Pet Sitters International, they go
uh-huh.
through the whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
so
good.
That,
so
yeah.
it's a whole process with this pet care business.
Yes, it is. You it's don't have to be, but if you want to be a legitimate business person, you have to be bonded
mm-hmm.
and insured.
And how do you babysit a bird? How?
Age, just bring them over to your house. Put him in the same room. Make sure he has sunlight and
mm-hmm.
feed him.
Do
just
you talk to them?
You can talk to them if you want to.
So
I talk,
you talk
to the dogs
to the animals?
Every day.
Really?
Every day.
Do
when we're in the car driving, it's like, okay, we're going to get there soon. Play music. I do the whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Do they respond as if they understand?
They lick me in the face or
in
on the cheek and stuff just to let me know that they love me.
Is there a different fee for the different type of animals that you service?
Definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.
All right, so
because a cat is less maintenance than a dog.
Right.
So for a dog, it's $35 a day.
Mm-hmm.
For a cat, it's $22.
Okay. And then a bird?
Bird, $15, $18.
A rabbit?
Really?
A rabbit is, that's the one thing. I'm reasonable because I know where I'm still in Harlem.
You're still in Harlem. Okay.
And I'm looking out for the little person also,
mm-hmm.
no
right.
matter what. I know it's hard for me to do it, and I'm not trying to mm-hmm. break anyone's pocket.
Did anyone right. ever bring any fish by you?
Actually, I did take care of a goldfish. 1 week,
a goldfish.
I had to go to their house.
I needed you. My third goldfish died when we went to Florida.
Oh, see?
Mm-hmm.
They had
yeah,
a fish
I know you're listening from
your
podcast.
And the fish, they had specific instructions for the,
mm-hmm.
fish,
really?
For the goldfish, yes.
Oh.
That was my first and only fish. Maybe
wow.
I'll get more, but.
Yeah, well, that's pretty interesting. It seems like you have a wide range of animals
yeah.
that you care for.
I do. I do not
and
take care of snakes or spiders. That's one thing
oh,
I
do
not
that.
Do.
No,
no snakes,
no spiders, please.
Okay, we're going to have to wrap this segment up. But right before we do, can you just give us your website and your phone number where people could reach out to you?
Sure. Once again, it's King's Pet Care. It's care with a K. And the number is 917-822-7367, and the website is www.kingspetcare.ws.
And that's care with a K.
Care with a K. And I'm based in Harlem, but I will travel.
She travels. Tell them.
All five boroughs, and that's including Staten Island.
And we're looking to expand in the summer.
All right.
Wow.
Well, thank you so much for coming,
thank
Bridget.
Thank you very much for
having
me.
And come back again
oh,
soon and talk
please.
To us after
we
you open up the
I
store.
Will,
I think I want my
all
daughter
right.
to come help you on the weekend.
Okay.
And
also,
very quickly, mention your internship very quickly. We
okay.
have a minute.
I am looking to expand. So if anyone is a extreme pet lover, please stop by the website, or you can like, I don't want a bunch of people knocking on the door. The dogs will go crazy. But you can either give me a call and we can set up an interview, or you can come by the web. Well, yes, just give me a call.
She wants you to really stop by.
Yeah, all right.
Just give me a call, and we can set up an interview, and I would be happy to interview you and see if you're ready to work with me.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Okay, next up we have
the People's Champion
with
Dr. Marcus.
Truth. The truth.
Yeah,
Dr. Marcus,
the truth.
Yeah, coming up right after us. Thanks again and
thanks.
Tune in next week.
Tuesday.
At 4 p.m.
Yes, with Shani and
Sandra.
Business
to business.
Business.
Thank you.
Turn them, turn your clippers on. Turn your clippers on.